Remember February 28, 2017? That Tuesday when the whole internet seemed broken? Slack, Quora, and Medium were among the sites that experienced a big-time fail that day. What was the deal, anyway? The answer is pretty simple. There was a problem in the cloud. You know the cloud. Your photos on Flickr, music on Spotify, your Google Docs, all in the cloud. Picture rows and rows of towering racks holding stacks of hard drives where users can access data they've stored or run applications through the internet. At least 70 data centers are located about an hour outside DC in Loudoun County, Virginia. And a lot of money is going into the cloud computing industry. Amazon Web Services, or AWS, brought in about $3.5 billion in revenue in 2016, about 8% of the company's overall revenue. We generally think of the cloud as pretty safe, should we? Ramnath Chalappa is the expert who first coined the term computing cloud. He says the only way to keep data truly safe from hackers would be to take everything off the network, put it in a lockbox, and throw away the key. Yeah, right. So how do we keep data in the cloud safe? Instead of physical barriers, cloud computing services use logic-based locks, like passwords and security questions, to keep hackers out. And they have experts monitoring their servers around the clock. They're looking for malware attacks, users connecting to bad IP addresses, and anyone trying to access info they shouldn't be able to see. But there's a problem with trusting other people to protect your information. They're just people. They can be subject to bribes, trickery, and good old-fashioned human error. In June, data on nearly 200 million Americans was exposed when files from a Republican analytics firm were left on a public cloud server without a password or any other protection. And the reason users couldn't access some sites that day in February? It turned out an AWS employee made a typo. Those keystrokes knocked out support systems that make AWS run properly. A typo? Clearly, cloud-based services aren't invincible. But they can be appealing to organizations that don't have cybersecurity at the core of what they do, like some federal government agencies, for example. The Department of Justice, Department of Defense, and FDA all use a cloud product. President Trump has ordered the government to look into wider cloud adoption across the federal government. That could make information sharing easier, as long as government workers properly label the information they want to store. An organization called FedRAMP was founded in 2011 to help federal agencies incorporate the cloud into their IT infrastructure. Chalappa says moving federal agencies to the cloud might be a huge investment in the short term, but it could pay off in security and productivity in the long term. As for your Flickr photos, it never hurts to back up your files on a CD or flash drive.